Even though Automobilista 2 just released 4 days ago, its developers apparently didn't take a break in the meantime, as they've already published the very first update for AMS 2. And as I promised in my last video, I am going to go over the rather significant changes of the new version. Starting off, there are a few changes to the game's appearance. The default values for the camera world movement, which is more or less responsible for how much your camera shakes, or rather the environment shakes while driving, has been increased from 50 to 75. But please don't misjudge this modification, as 75 camera world movement actually means the camera shakes less than with the value set to 50. Here is a short comparison between the former default value and the updated one. Furthermore, the GeForce effect in the camera settings was also reduced from 50 to 25. This is rather self-explanatory, as the GeForces will now be less noticeable when in cockpit cam, which essentially means your camera doesn't tilt as much in corners as before. Now we are approaching the more interesting parts of the update, namely changes to the physics and the AI. Firstly, some cars got slight adjustments in their tire tread physics. What these adjustments are is never really stated anywhere in Rezo's changelog, so I sadly can't tell you what exactly has changed. But what I can actually tell you is which cars are affected. These cars are the Formula Classic Gens 2 and 3, the Super V8s, the Mitsubishi Lancers, the Formula V, the Opala, the Ultima GTR, the Cobra trucks, the Caterhams, and also the karts. Now, the next change is a very welcoming one. At least in my opinion. The pneumatic trail for slick tires, as well as the max steering rack forces, were reduced to ensure more consistent feedback. So they did improve one point, which bothered me a bit, as I stated in my review of Automobilista 2. After the initial release, one thing a lot of players complained about was that apparently it is too easy for some cars to lock the brakes. So Rezo investigated and made one change for all cars, as well as some further adjustments to only a few. Generally speaking, the new default value for brake pressures was set to 90% for all cars. Furthermore, the Ultima GTR got a bug fixed, which caused its rear brakes to lock up way too easily. The supercar, on the other hand, saw its brake torque reduced to counteract the locking. And lastly, they fixed missing pre-warm tires for the F3 cars, as well as the Roco 001. Lastly, there were also some changes to the AI. But before you hype yourself, the AI adjustments are rather minor and will most likely not fix it completely. However, Rezo stated that they are aware of some problems of the AI and will continue working on it until Automobilista 2's final release, and also beyond, if necessary. But back to the adjustments. Basically, the AI got its tires adjusted for wet and dry conditions. Once again, not all cars were affected, so the AI for the following cars experienced some changes. The Caterhams, Touring Car Classics, the Ultima GTR, the RC Camaro, the Formula Vintage and the Formula Trainer got their dry tire AI adjusted. And the stock V8s, the Sprint Race cars, the Super V8s, the Caterhams, the Formula Classics, the Touring Car Classics and again the Formula Trainer got their wet tire AI adjusted. There is one last thing though, which seemed rather important to me. If you are still experiencing lockups during braking that happen way too easily, make sure to go into AMS2 settings for your wheel and recalibrate its pedals twice. Twice in a row actually. This is more or less a part-time solution though, until the underlying bug finally gets fixed. Now, if you want to check out the whole changelog for yourself, there is a link in the description. And if you want to be informed about future updates and what they change, be sure to hit the subscribe button in order to not miss anything. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!